So when I was a little kid in elementary school, we had this one day every year, and it was called Sports Day. And it was a day that every kid in the school looked forward to. In fact, couldn't wait to get to, because it was a day of no classes, and it would be in the spring, probably just a couple of weeks before the end of school, so the weather was warmer. And on the morning of Sports Day, every little kid would get to school so excited about what was about to happen. Because on that day, there would be all of these different competitions. I remember one was if you could carry a hard-boiled egg on a spoon through an obstacle course without having it fall off. And if you accomplished that task, then you would get a ribbon. So the idea was at the end of the day, you would have a whole bunch of ribbons pinned onto your shirt by the end of the day. But the most important of all of the competitions on Sports Day was the running race. And this was about a 100 meter long race, and there would just be three winners. There would be the first place, the second place, and the third place. And the competition for this race was super fierce. They would split up the boys, so there would be a boys' race and then there would be a girls' race. They would be separate. And all of the boys wanted desperately to be one of the three who would win one of the coveted ribbons from that running race. It was like the most important. It was the flagship event. So I remember one year, I actually won, I think it was second place in the running race, and I won this ribbon. And I remember the feeling of running home after school to show my parents and my sister this ribbon that I had won in the running race. I was so proud of it. Now, fast forward to when I had kids, and my kids were in elementary school and they were going to Sports Day. And by the time my kids got to Sports Day, they came home at the end of the day and they had all these ribbons and they were excited to show me the ribbons. And I said, so what did you win? Like what event did you win? And they hadn't won any events. They just got a ribbon for showing up. So it's like Sports Day from my generation is completely changed to what Sports Day is in this generation now, where you just get a ribbon for showing up. So what does this have to do with photography? Well, now I am running photography competitions, photo contests, and like I'm the guy in charge of Sports Day, and I have this decision. Am I going to give a ribbon to everyone who just shows up so that everyone has a warm and fuzzy feeling inside? Or will there be ribbons based on achievement and accomplishment for having great photos? And that's really the direction that we are going, because competition is fierce out there in the world. Competition is fierce for those who want to sell their photos. You have to have fantastic photos if someone's going to pay money for them. Even on social media where no one's buying anything, competition is fierce for clicks and likes. And if your photos don't look fantastic, you're not going to get the clicks and the likes. You're not going to be elevated. You're not going to get that little dopamine rush when somebody clicks on one of your photos. So the question that I get asked as I'm going through even 1,000 photos at a time to judge these photos in a photo contest is, what do you look for? What makes a winning photo a winning photo? What makes a photo stand out from all the rest? Is it entirely just subjective, like it's just 100% opinion based, or is there an objective element to it as well? And there is. And what it all comes down to, it is, here's the German way of saying three things. It is composition, composition, and composition. So your photo's composition is the cornerstone. It's the foundation of your photo. If you don't have a great composition, then your photo is not going to stand out. It's going to be a fatal flaw. You cannot recover from not having a good composition. And the way that you do that is twofold. Number one, you need to be using the storytelling in your photography so that you have identified a hero in the story, you've cropped out the villains. And number two is that you are using as many as possible of the tried and true rules of composition within your photo. And I call that composition rule stacking, where you are taking a photo and combining numerous rules of composition into that photo. When you do those two things, you are going to have a composition that will make your photo stand out from all the rest. That is really the baseline advice I can give you for how to win photo competitions or just how to make your photography stand out. And if you want to know more about this, I have an entire 1-hour module inside the Photography Transformation Masterclass just on compositions and how to do storytelling, how to identify the hero of the story, how to find the right type of foregrounds, and how to stack the rules of composition. So if it's something you're interested in, then click the link and check out the free web class where I tell you all about these principles and as well all about the masterclass. Thanks for watching, and remember, composition, composition, and composition. And I hope you get one of the coveted 3 ribbons in our next photo contest. There are some photographers who believe that to be a great photographer, you need to have your camera in manual mode all the time. And to that, I say no. You keep your camera in manual mode all the time and you're going to miss those moments, and then they're gone forever. There are no natural born photographers. It must be learned, and you need to choose someone who you're going to learn it from. My name is Tim Shields. I help people become award-winning photographers, and I can help you.